blessings of God. I have the joy down in my heart, down in my heart, way down in my heart. I have the joy down in my heart. Glory to his name. I have the joy down in my heart. Well, down in my heart. Well, down in my heart. Glory to his name. I have the peace that passeth understanding down in my heart. Well, down in my heart. Well, down in my heart. I have the peace that passeth understanding down in my heart. Well, down in my heart. Well, down in my heart. I have the peace that passeth understanding down in my heart. Glory to his name. Amen.
Welcome to the episode number 40. Today we're talking about from Matthew chapter 6 verse 13. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Is temptation a sin?
Thank you, Elizabeth, for your good, the recitation of the Word of God. We are doing on episode number 40, right?
Right.
Okay. So your question is temptation?
Is it sin?
Yes, sin, right? Actually, temptation is not a sin. But Jesus taught us in our prayer, lead us not into temptation. Means the aftermath of temptation is the biggest problem. Because everybody has the temptation. Tempting for doing bad things. Evilness. Like a sins, But Jesus taught us, pray for, do not put us into the temptation. The temptation is a natural a passion or a desire or a longing just to. Everybody has it. Because we live in this sinful world with this terrestrial body. Temptation is there. But actually the meaning of what Jesus is telling us to pray to God, do not lead us into the temptation, means the temptation may lead us to do, committing sins. So we need God's blessings and a favor to not to commit a sin. Right? Yeah, that's what it is. So temptation should not lead us to commit a sin. So we may lose the joy. Because the moment we through the temptation, when the moment we commit a sin, we lose the joy. Like we sang, I have the joy down in my heart. That's the joy is from God. That joy. So
how to avoid the devil?
How to avoid the devil? That's a very good, lovely question. Thank you, Elizabeth. Why we don't want to commit any sin? Why we don't want to? Because anybody does sin, they are against God, and they will not get the eternal life. They are still under the control of devil. So, love of Jesus is a secret. See what I'm saying? If we love Jesus, then we don't want to do any sin. We hate to do sin. We don't want to, because we know that when people doing a sin, there is some kind of fun in it. You know, some kind of fun. That's why people are addicted to commit sin. You know, you name it, any sins. But the thing is, there is that fun is, that joy is only temporary, only for a moment. But after committing sin, we will lose the joy of the presence of God. And the guilt will come into our heart. You know, guilt, the guilty conscience. Then we cannot even make a good laugh or a smile or love other people. Then the selfishness, ego, hatred, anger, you know, retaliation, gossip, you know, murdering, thinking, and selfishness, those kind of stuff. Those are the stuffs of devil. We don't like it. But actually, so answer to your question is, how we avoid the devil means love Jesus and stick with Jesus. Receive Jesus into our life. So once Jesus is received into our heart, Jesus likes, Jesus passion, Jesus vision will rule in our life, and Jesus will be our Savior, and Jesus interest will be our interest, Jesus passion will be our passion, Jesus mindset will be our mindset, right? So that way, when Jesus is presented in our life, Bible says our old sins will be forgiven and our names will be written in the book of the life. Then we wanted to walk with Jesus, talk like Jesus, and do the things of what Jesus likes, and we hate what? The sins, right? We don't find any pleasure in committing sin. So whenever we see a sin, an opportunity of sin, we hate it. We don't want it, because the presence of God in us. So in order to come to that situation, what we have to do? Jesus says in the Lord's Prayer, what he says? Jesus taught his disciple when we pray, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. That is a good verse. And for the last couple of episodes, you know, we were thinking and talking and discussing about exposing an application of the Word of God, you know, the Lord's Prayer. And today we concluded that one. Right? Good job. Thank you, Elizabeth, for doing it and asking your valuable questions. Definitely this will help everybody, you know. So as usual, do you want to make a final remarks to the viewers of the social media?
Yes, if you like this small message, you can share it with your friends, and they can share their friends.
Yeah.
So everybody can hear the message, this good message.
Okay. Thank you, Elizabeth. And until next Sunday morning, 8 o'clock, say bye and God's blessings.